Hi, it's Alina here. So I am going to talk about my remote viewing of the Dulce underground base facility near New Mexico. So I had done this a couple of weeks ago in early April, I believe. Yes, April 2017. So when I was remote viewing it, it was a blind target at first, so I didn't know that it was a Dulce base. So what happened is this. I started receiving a bunch of images, seeing this squarish type building underground. Well, it's a facility base, basically. So, and it's square, and it kind of has these rectangular edges to it, underground to deep underground. So it starts off with an underground tunnel with roads to enter the base. There's two different roads, so to speak. One going into the base and one going out of it. And so when you enter the base and you go in, there's an astrophysics / cartography lab. So they do astrophysics work, and there they test things out to see what's going on with astrophysics and cartography stuff. That's one of the labs they have. Then they also have a specialized testing room with a mini CERN collider in there, where they test different particle beams, different energy sources. That's what these mini CERNs do. There's also an interesting hangar dock bay on the left-hand side of the base. And it has beyond the speed of light flight ships, reverse engineered from alien ships. So I saw six of these hovering circular type ships in the hangar bay, in the docking bay, and it's light stream engines in the ships. So they are working with alien technology that they've reversed engineered. That's quite interesting for me. And I've heard that the Dulce base has ETs working with conjunction with human military staff in there. So it's not just humans in that base. There's also ETs in there. They also have a bunch of science division labs, three of them that I could see in the middle of the base. They also have a frequency match planet travel portal gateway technology. There's this huge arc, and there's energy vortexes coming in from that arc. So it's a star gateway portal that they have. And it's in a specialized huge room that is separated by some kind of a energy shield from the rest of the science division's labs, because these portals that are created by the gateway, they're huge. There's this arc that staff go through and it teleports them to other places on the planet, and possibly even to other planets beyond Earth. So there's viewing windows from this isolated room. There's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 different windows. And there's also control rooms. There's also like 9 of these control rooms around, and there's windows in those rooms. And they monitor how the gateway frequency match planet travel portal works. So they constantly monitor it to see how it's used, how it works, is it safe or not. So they do a lot of different stuff in there with that technology. There's also water matter testing that they do, and that's in a separate building attached to the base. And from what I could energetically sense, it was time warp matrix stabilization technology of some sort that they're doing with the water matter testing technology that they have. They also have an earthquake generator technology machine. So they can create man-made earthquakes with that machine. And they have a seismic topography lab. No coincidence, because they have the earthquake machine. So they also have that seismic topography lab to study the telemetry data from when they use the earthquake generator. Unfortunately, the thing is, when you use earthquake machines to create earthquakes, there's mass energy influxes coming from those machines, which creates layers of energy flux matrix beside the base. And sometimes that energy matrix becomes unstable beside the base, and it could cause damage to the base itself, to the infrastructure of the land beside the base and the base itself. So it's like a powder keg that's waiting to go off, which makes it unsafe to use this earthquake generator technology that they have. It's unethical, in my opinion, that they have this tech, but they play around with that stuff all the time in these underground secret base facilities. And Dulce has been around for a long time. There's also a back entrance to the base from the other attached building where the water matter testing technology is, the earthquake generator, and the seismic topography lab. So there's a back entrance to the main base building and that separate building. So there's a second entrance. There's also about four other buildings at the front of the base, not attached to the base itself. And these buildings are called the antimatter conversion testing facilities. So they're testing beam weapons. They're also testing particle beam transmitter array. So they're doing that as well beside the Dulce base. So it's a big facility, and it deals with exotic technology, testing exotic matter technology, and reviewing the telemetry results of these tests and experiments, and refining the results, improving the technology to make it better, and retesting it again and doing that over and over until it's perfect. So, and it's both ETs and human military from these black projects working on this stuff. So that's what I had seen in the Dulce base when I remote viewed it. Afterwards, after I had done the blind remote viewing session, what I did was I went on the internet once I knew what I had remote viewed. Once I was told what the heck I was remote viewing, I went on the internet and I typed in Dulce Base Underground Facility, and I saw a bunch of maps. There's 7 maps of it with this exact same building that I remote viewed and drew. I saw that in the maps, and it says that it's Google Maps. What the base looks like on the surface of the Earth. So it looks square with different edges to it, because it's not just perfectly square, it has edges to it, and another, a few different buildings attached, and roadways leading in and out from the base, from the surface on the ground, there's roadways, and also roadway entrances going underground. There's also mining shafts and tunnels near the base of old mines and stuff that have been reused to get access to the base. So that's what I saw on the map, what's on the surface of the ground, surface ground base, and underneath also what the facility looks like underneath, underground, not just on the surface. Because there's buildings on the surface ground levels, there's also buildings, so nobody suspects what the heck's going on. And underground, there's more build out of that main testing facility of the exotic technology. So, basically, there's a lot of structures on the surface and on the underground levels of the base. And the maps showed the exact thing as what I had basically drawn during the RV, that this was an irregularly shaped squarish building, huge base building underground with other building areas attached to the main base, and 4 antimatter conversion testing facilities near the base itself underground, huge hangar docking bay. It has a huge entrance to that bay where they keep the reverse engineered light stream ships from alien technology, where they're testing that. And I'm sure other different craft are also tested there, because they can't help themselves. They want to reverse engineer as much technology as they can from ETs. Humans are curious lots, so that's why they have all of this testing stuff in that base. So the maps just gave me some validation of what I remote viewed, the maps that I found on the internet of what this thing looks like, the Dulce base underground facility. So I'll attach that in this description presentation, and also what I remote viewed, my drawing of this RV session. And it's very interesting. This is my real big RV of an underground base facility. Generally, I try not to remote view these things because they have protection. They have their own psychics that basically shield other remote viewers from looking into these bases, from remote viewing them. So those people that are trying to remote view underground bases, be careful, because sometimes there's booby traps and there's psychic shields that will cause you to be in a sort of fog when you try to see into the RV of an underground base. Because there are these exotic matter technologies there, weapons, other stuff that ETs have and want to work on in secret with Earth governments, military, these black-funded projects with the military-industrial complex, all these other programs, the SSPs, the ICCs. There's so many different programs, and most of that stuff is worked in secret and underground bases, or off-planet for that matter. So whatever you're remote viewing, just be careful so you don't fall into booby traps, psychic ones, or even energetic ones, because there are some, and there's shields and blocks as well. So just make sure you're energetically protected when you do this stuff, and don't just blindly go and remote view something without having protection for yourself. It's very important to have that protection. Make sure your energy shields are impenetrable, your bubble is up, you're energetically balanced, you're feeling well, If you're not feeling well, you know, there's an ailment or an imbalance of some sort, health is not perfect health-wise, I would suggest maybe then doing the remote viewing at a different time, because if you're not totally healthy, then energetically doing a remote viewing can be detrimental. So you need to be at your strongest when remote viewing. Having a clear mind, good health, doing it on a good day that you feel comfortable doing it on, and make sure your shields are healthy and strong, your energetic shields, so they don't detect you when you go to do the remote viewing, and that you're invisible when you're doing it, so you don't trigger any booby traps or energetic type encounters that can cause some trouble for you. Because their psychics, their energy psychics can sense you and send energy back at you to disable you from doing the remote viewing. So make sure you know how to protect yourself. You have a good shield around yourself, energetic shield. Because for me, I don't just go willy-nilly remote viewing things without having my energy shields up and being fully protected when I do this stuff. So that's just from my own experience. So thank you and namaste.